The Debate, written and read by Steve Parker.
Of all your reprehensible criminal acts, that is the worst thing you've done,
roared the blue adjutant, iridescent with rage as he slapped an open palm down on the plasteel bench before him, glaring at his opposite across the room.
You use the word progressive as if it's some kind of slur.
It is when used as you use the word, roared back the red adjutant, just as baleful as his opponent.
His crimson robes momentarily tangled as he threw his arms high in the air to punctuate his point.
You would have us progress blindly for progress's sake, without respect for the past, without due consideration of morality.
Morality! Shrieked the speaker in blue. What kind of morality do you mean? The morality of killing our own people, or that of sitting back while they kill themselves and each other?
Oh, really?
Chuckled the red speaker dismissively.
Or perhaps you mean the morality of forcing a primitive philosophy on people who have advanced beyond your Bronze Age superstition?
How dare you? Screamed the red adjutant,
making as if to leap over the table and physically attack the blue speaker.
Gentlemen, please,
called a third man, bedecked in a simple white tunic, with an air of calm unpossessed by the other two. He gently tapped a golden ball on a steel platform in front of him, and the sound reverberated around the room like a small thunderstorm.
If we cannot maintain a state of calm, nothing will be achieved here today.
Both the other men started up again as if to continue their argument.
If you had one half,
and I think we all know that something must be achieved. Things have gone far too far in our world outside this chamber. Mere civil war would be a children's party when compared to what awaits us if we fail. I beg you, both of you, maintain your calm and speak with intelligence, consideration, and humility. We represent a species on the very edge of disaster, gentlemen. The stakes could not possibly be higher.
There was a certain amount of shameful shuffling in the room, quickly covered in dignity as all present returned to their seats and eyed their pre-prepared points.
All I want to know, continued the blue-robed speaker, is what alternatives do we have? We must progress or we will stagnate.
Nonsense, returned the speaker in red. What you call stagnation, we call stability. A return to our founding principles and a time when things were not so
multicultural, egalitarian,
muddled,
concluded the man in red, with a pointed look at his opposite.
But don't you see, everything good in our lives came from progress. If people had never progressed, we would not have medicine.
These plagues are a punishment for turning away from the old teachings. With sufficient faith, we would not need medicine.
We would not have our magnificent infrastructure of roads, great centers of art, libraries, schools.
I need only one book, which hardly requires a library. And I need no knowledge which cannot be learned in one of our great temples.
Ah, and who built those temples? Surely you do not believe that they were built without recourse to the progress made by builder after builder who learned and passed on their knowledge to the next generation. Bah!
Ejaculated the man in red.
This is getting us nowhere. You are a man of words.
I am a man of science.
And you have no respect for my faith.
And you have no respect for my learning.
Your learning is nothing in the face of the truths taught by our elders.
Truths? You mean that primitive nonsense forced into the soft heads of children because
you say that again?
I dare
you!
No, and I challenge your claim of intelligence.
Silence!
The golden ball slammed again into the platform which held it, this time with enough force to almost deafen the master debaters. The speaker in white glared at the two before him as if they were petulant children, which in his eyes, they were. When he spoke, It was with a low growl which left the two men in no illusion as to the mood of the neutral mediator.
"I cannot believe this. With so much at stake, can you really find no common ground? You..."
He thrust a gnarled finger to his right at the man in blue.
"You who claim such intelligence, and you..."
He swung the savage digit and stabbed at the gaping man in red.
"Who claims such wisdom? Both of you argue like small-minded simpletons, squabbling over who will get to speak as if they and only they hold the key to the only truth in the universe."
The man stood and glared down at the two speakers, who both cringed into their seats.
"Can you truly not understand that there are as many truths in existence as there are consciousnesses in the multiverse? Forcing your pitifully limited belief systems on anyone is a horrible crime. Trying to force them on everyone is the very height of arrogant contempt."
He rounded on the man in red.
"If people choose to believe your teachings, so be it. But there it must rest. You cannot force people to believe what they cannot. Neither can you expect them to live by laws which only exist in the context of those teachings. They make no sense to anyone else. Keep your teaching inside your temples. Comfort and support each other with them, and no one will ever oppose it."
He turned to the man in blue.
"And you must do the same."
He turned once more to face them both.
"If you fail in this, gentlemen, we all know what will happen."
Their thoughts turned outside the building in which they sat, where billions of people waited, armed to the teeth and ready to kill or die based on the next words to come out of the building. Great armies with horribly beweaponed tools of war, ready to unleash them on their almost identical opposites with the slightest provocation.
"So," said the speaker in white, "what will it be?"
You have been listening to The Debate, written and read by Steve Parker.